Jesus. Oh,
I've been getting it since a toddler. I keep dollars on my head. Been a real one is my motto. Hell, my problems, I ain't scared.
Yo, welcome back, Pacer Nation, Pacer Station fans everywhere, ladies and gentlemen. Now, today we got a very, 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 very special video for y'all. As a lot of y'all may know, the Pacers have drafted Cassius Stanley out of Duke University with the 54th overall draft pick in the 2020 NBA draft. Now, before we get started with what Cassius will mean to Indiana as an organization and what I think his career will look like heading into the NBA, I'd like to congratulate every player that was drafted last night. Shout out specifically Jay Scrub with the Trinity High School here in my hometown, Louisville, Kentucky. Really happy to see him be the first player ever drafted straight from JUCO into the league. Making history out there. Congratulations, Jaden. And congratulations to everyone that was drafted. Great to see kids get drafted. Life-changing stuff, knowing that they're going to be financially stable for years and years to come. And also knowing that they're going to get to fulfill a dream, because a lot of these guys have been dreaming for this for a long, long time. And Cassius Stanley is not an exception to this. Cassius Stanley has been playing basketball for a long, long time. He was a viral sensation in high school. I remember when he was at Sierra Canyon. I was in high school myself. Every time I got on my phone, it seemed like I saw a different Cassius Stanley dunk. Kid is super athletic, can jump out of the gym, crazy athleticism, and he was projected to be maybe a top 10 pick when he entered college. A lot of people saw a lot of potential in him and his athleticism. Didn't come into college and play the way that he did in high school, I'd say. It was a bit of a learning curve for him. I feel like he said, though, I've done a lot of research on Cassius since we drafted him. And he said in one of the interviews I saw, specifically of Gilbert Arenas interviewed him on his little podcast. I forgot what Gilbert Arenas' podcast is called, but he interviewed him. And Cassius said, here, I'll go ahead and let him tell y'all what he said.
Last year, I learned, my main goal was to learn. And I feel like I learned a lot. I learned a lot about myself in the game. And off the court, that was my main goal. 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, I don't care. I want to learn. I learned a lot, that was what it was. So I guess to answer your question, I feel like I learned it.
So there you have it. I don't think Cassius's goal was to come in. I think he kind of knew going in that he was going to be one and done no matter what. But as long as he learned something, I think that was going to be the case. He didn't have the season that he wanted to, I don't think. I don't think he had the season that Duke fans wanted him to. But he learned a lot, and you could see him progress throughout the season. And develop into something that eventually still got drafted. So a lot to be excited about if we are Pacers fans. So first and foremost, what does this mean for the Pacers team? To be completely honest, I don't think it means anything yet. I think he might start off as a two-way player, who knows, going back and forth from the G League and the roster, just because we're really a guard-heavy team right now with Aaron Holiday, Edmund Sumner on the bench, Oladipo, Brogdon, of course, the starters. But I don't know where Cassius will fit on this team right now, but in the future, I think Cassius Stanley can. His ceiling is all-star. His ceiling is super athletic, Russell Westbrook-like shooting guard player, a guy who can score tremendously. He has the size of someone who can be an elite defender sometime down the road with good coaching, and I think Nate Bjorkgren can bring that. Once being an assistant coach on a great defensive team in Toronto. So Cassius Stanley, if he can develop into a great defender, I think the offense will come. And I think the reason they drafted him was because Bjorkman needs guys and wants guys that can run, that will get up and down the court fast. He wants to play fast. He wants to run. And that's exactly what you're getting out of guys like Cassius Stanley. Cassius Stanley can run. He can jump. He's super athletic. And he's a great scorer when it comes to driving the ball.
As far as three-point shooting, now you saw Cassius Stanley take a lot of threes in high school, and majority of them went in. In college, I believe he was a 36% three-point shooter, so he's the guy who in the league, I don't expect him to be a liability from the three, but I also don't expect him to be a guy who will carry the load from deep or anything of that nature. He's going to be a guy who is more so of a slasher than a sharpshooter. Now, what does this pick mean for me? meaning Big Pace and Pacer Station. I love the pick, absolutely love it. I absolutely love the Pacers getting a guy like Cassius Stanley. He's box office, and if he pans out, I think he'll be a starter on this team one day down the road.
I don't know if it'll be soon, simply because Brogdon and Vic are here, but if Vic were to leave in the coming years, I think a guy like Cassius Stanley might have a higher ceiling than guys like Aaron Holiday and even Edmund Sumner. So I see Cassius Stanley definitely, possibly one day down the road, being a really big piece of this Pacers team if he pans out. Now, his floor, something I don't want to talk about, because if Cassius Stanley doesn't pan out and he cut in his jump from college into the NBA is a lot like his jump from high school to college, it's not going to be a good pick, and eventually he'll be out of the league in 3 to 4 years. That's just my prediction if he doesn't pan out. Now, do I think he'll pan out? Cassius Stanley, I see him as a guy. He's a great, great kid. Okay, and I said that before we drafted anyone. I said whoever we draft is going to be a great guy off the court. Bjorkgren doesn't want to start his time in Indy with picking up guys at a risk. I think Cassius Stanley is a great, great, great dude. He seems really chill in all the interviews you see, humble. Seems like he wants to learn and get better. Doesn't seem cocky, too confident, or anything like that. And going to the University of Duke, going to Duke University is going to mean a lot for him entering the league, I feel like. When you have to play on a team where you're not the guy that is needed, on a team that doesn't need you, you learn a lot about playing your role on a team. So being part of a Duke team that had, who was it, Vernon Carey, Trey Jones, and all them, I think it's gonna bode well for him entering the league, just like it bodes well for many other guys that went to Kentucky or Duke or UCLA, etc., the big schools. What does this mean for Cassius? I think for Cassius Stanley, this is a great landing spot for him. I think it's a place where he can learn and get better at without being pressured to jump in right away, but still will get his moments. I think he'll get a chance to make the final roster and be a rotational piece on this team from day one. I think he'll have his chance. What he will do with that chance is yet to be seen. But like I said at the beginning of the video, there's also a chance he plays maybe his first 2 years or so in the G League. So you never really know with guys like Cassius Stanley. He's a high risk, high reward kind of guy. I see all-stars ceiling, and I see huge bust out of the league soon floor. Let's dive a little bit more into Cassius' strength. So, like I've been saying this entire video, he can jump and run out of the gym. Super athletic kid, 6'6", about 195 last I checked. I think he can build a little bit more to his frame if he wants to get more minutes in the league, because the league, you're going to get bumped around if you're coming in 190. At the two spot, but I really do think Cassius Stanley, if he can build a frame, I think he'll be an elite defender in the league. Cassius is still maturing in terms of physicality and contributing off the ball. I feel like he really can get better in those two areas when his frame gets built into a little bit more, once he gets a little bit more meat on his bones, because his lateral quickness is insane. He can really, really, really move. Especially at the two spot, and that's great for a 6'6 guy who's going to need to guard guys like Klay Thompson on the outside, guys like James Harden, even a craftier scorer. So it's really, really good to have the frame he has right now, but I think getting a little stronger will go miles for this kid. He uses his speed very, very wisely. He uses his jumping ability very, very wisely as well on the defensive end. You see a lot of blocks come from just his jumping ability alone. He doesn't really have to even time his blocks too much sometimes. Just simply off his wingspan and his jumping ability, you can see blocks come easy to him at times, especially from a two-spot position. Am I glad we got him instead of a wing player? A lot of people ask me how do I feel about us getting a guard. And I think eventually Cassius Stanley, if he can really grow into the defensive player, I think he can. He'll be able to guard the three spot, and maybe even the four spot if he builds the way Giannis did. If he builds his frame the way Giannis did, you look at Giannis from his rookie year to now, it's a completely different player in terms of strength. So I feel like if Cassius Stanley can do something in that area of building strength and grow in that way, you can really see him grow into an elite defender, somewhat of a guy who can guard wings instead of just guards. Although he's not too long, like I said earlier, his wingspan is enough that with his leaping ability, it's enough to get a lot of blocks without even having to time things correctly. But that will have to be changed in the league
he will have to have a little bit better timing because there's way better athletes in the league who will be closer to him in athleticism. I feel like Cassius Stanley is a guy who, and we're going to talk a little bit about his offense now and his skills. When it comes to his dunking ability, one of the most fun parts of basketball, as we all know, Cassius Stanley could be the winner of a dunk contest in 1 or 2 years. No doubt in my mind. He's going to be one of the best dunkers in the league off the bat. If he does play in the league off the bat instead of the G League, he'll be probably the best dunker on any team he plays in throughout his career. And hopefully it'll be in Indiana, and hopefully it'll be as a pretty good player. So, yeah, offensively, I think the one thing that he's going to need to work on is consistency. He did show a little bit of promise as a floor spacer every once in a while at Duke. He did show a lot of promise when it comes to finishing at the rim in transition. And I think that's really what Nate Bjorkman wants. He wants to run. He wants to get out and transition real fast. And a guy like Cassius Stanley fits that mold beautifully, probably better than almost anyone in the bottom of this draft did. Great pick, I feel like, by the Pacers. I'll give it a B-plus pick simply because I really wanted us to get Chase Scrub. A B-plus pick for this, or B-plus grade for this pick by the Pacers. I feel like Cassius Stanley does have a spot on this roster. And he'll prove it by the end of the year, I feel like. I feel like he'll come in with a chip on his shoulder after falling that much and almost not getting drafted at all. He'll definitely come into the league with a chip on his shoulder playing for a team where he says half of his family already lives at. So he's basically coming home. Welcome, Cassius, to the team. Can't wait to see you play this year. I'm super hyped that we got a box office kind of talent. A guy who was a viral sensation at one point. It's always fun to have those kind of guys. Especially in comparison to drafting guys like Goga Batadze, who, while he's a great player, don't get me wrong, he could develop into an all-star, I say. It's not the sexiest pick or the most fun pick that could be picked at that moment in time by the Pacers. So always great to see a big-name guy get drafted into a small market like Indiana. And can't wait to see what Cassius Stanley will do in a Pacers jersey. So make sure you follow us at Pacers Station on all social media platforms. Pacer Nation. We are Deuces.